everyone. I'll just do some quick introductions to start with. I know you know you've kind of met everybody, but I'd like to introduce Dr. George Pylypchuk. And George is our unified head of medicine for the Saskatoon Health Region and College of Medicine. Introduce you to Dr. Julian Tam, who we're thrilled to have with us on staff right now. And as you know from the news release, he is our new respirologist, specializes in cystic fibrosis, which is tremendous. And Dr. Pylypchuk has a lot of things to say about how important that's going to be for our patients and clients. Really thrilled to be able to introduce Joan Liddington to you. Joan has a son who has cystic fibrosis, and I know she's a member of the local CF chapter, and we're pleased to have her here for her perspective along with Dr. Tam joining us. So Dr. Pylypchuk and Dr. Tam are just going to make a couple of introductory comments, and then we'll open it up to questions for you. Go ahead, George.
Thanks, Linda. So it's really exciting for us to be here today. It's a good news story, and it's always nice to get a good news story. We are very happy from our Department of Medicine to introduce Dr. Julian Tam, who actually is our first new hire on the new academic clinical funding plan put up by the provincial government. And the academic clinical funding plan is a method for us to bring in various physicians, and in this case, a very highly specialized physician to help us deal with the population of respiratory patients in our province. But this plan really allows us to bring in physicians and allows us to bring them in either for clinical activities, for teaching activities, and for research activities. And this is really important because in the past, what has happened, we found that many of our teachers, when we brought in teachers, we found that many of them ended up having to do a lot of clinical work, and they were overburdened with clinical work, fully overloaded, and the teaching time wasn't as much as we would like to have gotten. So this new plan that we have, which is a provincial plan, is a partnership between the provincial government, between the College of Medicine and the regional health authorities, again, to bring in people who we need to teach, do clinical services, and to do research. So I'm very pleased to introduce Dr. Julian Tam, who is, for our Department of Medicine, our first individual to be hired under this program, and he brings with him a tremendous amount of expertise.
Julian? Well, thanks, Dr. Pylypchuk. I'm very excited to be here. Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease that can affect different organs in the body. In particular, it's known for causing lung disease and can cause recurrent episodes of lung infections. Some individuals with CF can actually develop end-stage severe lung disease, eventually requiring lung transplantation. The median age of cystic fibrosis has actually exceeded 50 years in Canada, but it's still important to recognize that CF can cause morbidity and mortality in young patients still.
Go ahead and open it up for questions.
What are you hoping to accomplish with your work here?
So I actually did some of my medical training here at the University of Saskatchewan, and I recognize that we have a very committed and enthusiastic multidisciplinary CF team. I hope to bring the skills and knowledge that I have gained during my fellowship in cystic fibrosis in Toronto to complement the expertise of our local team.
So we don't do lung transplants here.
That's correct.
Is it a possibility now that you're here?
So you're correct. We currently do not do lung transplants here, but I will be working alongside Dr. Mark Fenton, who runs a satellite clinic and works closely with the transplant team in Edmonton. So we certainly are able to help our patients with severe lung disease by working with the Edmonton group to connect them to the experts should they eventually require lung transplantation.
And that's where they would go now?
Correct.
How many people specialize now in the region just in regards to adult cystic fibrosis?
So right now we have three individuals who've been, Connie and Julia, two prior who've been working in this program, one of which is now on a sabbatical.
Is there any way that you could just do individual?
Oh yeah,
sure. Sorry, it's just a bit of a awkward.
Nope, you got it. So just going to do one-on-one interviews.
Well, just have you stand. That's just a little awkward.
Yeah.
You guys did.
Oh, yeah, no, we're pretty flexible.
Yeah.
Actually, we're pretty young here. So let's get you to stand directly in front of the camera, toes pointed towards the camera.
And should I be?
Nope, you're busy.
Okay.
Sure, sir.
Said I'm rolling.
So why were you compelled to sort of tackle cystic fibrosis as opposed to the other situation?
So I think it was largely based on some meaningful clinical experiences I had early on in my training. I had met and looked after some patients with CF, and it in some ways inspired me to want to pursue CF as a clinical niche.
You sort of addressed it when you were talking about how severe is having CF?
Great question. So there can be a wide range of disease severity in cystic fibrosis. Some patients have minimal lung disease, and on the contrary, some patients can have quite advanced lung disease as well. So CF can have a broad spectrum of disease severity.
So it's maybe no longer a death sentence.
Well, I would say that it's, as I had alluded to earlier, CF still has the potential to cause morbidity and mortality in patients at a young age, but with recent advances in research, I think it brings hope to patients and their caregivers, both in the present as well as in the future.
Will you be doing any research while you're here or just clinical work?
I will be doing some research here as well.
Specifically related to cystic fibrosis.
Correct.
Okay. And for any of our viewers who are not familiar with it, what causes cystic fibrosis?
So cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease, and with the faulty gene, a defective protein results, which leads to abnormal ion transport, and through this mechanism, the different manifestations of CF can result.
Okay. And I'm wondering, with parents, I understand that there's a possibility, 25% chance that they would have a child without it, a 25% chance that they would have a child with it, and 50% chance that they would have a carrier. Is that correct? That's what CF Canada is saying.
So for people, so CF it is a genetic disease, and some people can carry the gene without actually having the condition.
At this point, what are the treatment options?
So the treatment for cystic fibrosis can be complex and time intensive. Some patients with CF have to take multiple oral medications every single day. They may also need to take inhaled medications such as antibiotics or treatments that help them clear the secretions in their lungs. They may also require insulin injections if they have CF-related diabetes. Patients who have lung disease often also benefit from chest physiotherapy to help them clear the secretions from their airways as well. So there are multiple complicated treatments that CF patients have to take care of on a day-to-day basis.
Why did you feel like the Saskatoon Health Region was the right fit?
So I had a great time in Saskatoon during my residency in internal medicine and fellowship in respirology here. And I was inspired to want to come back here, to work alongside my mentors. And I also recognized that there was an opportunity to help improve upon the care of patients with CF.
Why adults and not everyone?
So my background is in adult medicine.
Okay, and you're from this area, or where are you from?
I grew up in Burlington, Ontario.
Okay, and how old are you?
I'm 30.
Okay. Thank you so much.